So I can start off this on this point. Is you will learn everywhere. You will learn in in-house counsel also. You will learn in a law firm also. It depends upon what you want to learn. Now, this is the practical aspect of it, where I wanted to come to. Is when you're working in a law firm, as other people have also pointed out, you will invariably, in most of the law firms, you will be part of one single team. If you are doing capital markets, which is to do with IPOs and QIPs and SEBIs and takeover codes and all of that, ICDRs and all of that. If you are doing capital market, you will only do capital market. Aapko M&A, private equity, joint ventures, project finance, banking and insurance, nahi idea lagega. You will not have an idea what is happening in those areas, including litigation. But you would have worked on capital market, but for various companies and handling various issues. So you would have built an expertise on the capital market side as a capital market lawyer. You would have dealt with, when you deal with many companies, every company will have different issues. Yes, you are dealing with the same law, but the exposure is different from a practical point of view. As a corporate lawyer, you deal more with commercials and less with law. As a litigation, you deal maximum with the law. As a corporate lawyer, your commercial understanding has to be very good. So you will deal more with those issues. When you work in an in-house counsel, your client is only one. But you are dealing with all the issues under the umbrella, right from litigation, as she pointed out, she has been to police station also, you're doing everything. There you tend to acquire more of a generalist role. But again, depending upon if the industry is a specific industry, if the industry is in real estate or is in aviation, you will develop skill set of a specialized lawyer in that particular industry also. So learning to har jagah hi hai. When you start after a law graduate, you have to, only you can decide what you want to do, whether you want to become a corporate lawyer or whether you want to join an in-house counsel. There are various attributes involved. People have pointed out what it requires for a law firm, what it requires to be an in-house counsel. You have to know what kind of qualities I have to be better suited. My practical advice is to all the students is don't sit idle on your CV for more than 6 months, because that is not reflected good on any, for example, you want to do a law firm job, but you are not able to find a good law firm of your choice. So don't wait for more than 6 months. Jo 6 months tak agar aapko nahi mil raha hai, whatever you want, then just settle here. Unfortunately, I have to say this, but yes, settle for whatever you're getting in hand. Don't waste beyond 6 months. Don't kill your CV. It should not be blank. And then later on, you will have time. After 2 years, 3 years, you will again have time to switch to what you always wanted to do. Absolutely. Absolutely. Don't kill your CV. But if your CV reflects that you have been sitting idle, everybody will ask you in your interview, they are going to ask, this is the first question which you will be asked, that what were you doing for 6 months? You can't say that I've been trying to find a job for 6 months. They'll say, what? You can't find a job in 6 months. So don't sit on your CV.